Hello, I'm going to be doing a love reading for Cancer for the month of April 2017. Spirit, this is going to be for Cancer. April 2017, please, love reading. Okay, I am using the Romance Angels Oracle cards by Doreen Virtue. I'm also going to be pulling one card each off of the traditional Rider-Waite Tarot deck. I'm going to place that on top of each angel card, just as a clarifier. Spirit, this is for Cancer, April 2017, please. April 2017, please. This is for Cancer. All right, let's get started. First card is engagement. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. With that card came the Chariot. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. Not sure how I'm feeling about that yet. Attraction. You attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. Stopping to smell the roses. Ace of Pentacles. Unrequited love. There is not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. Along with the Page of Pentacles. Usually for my readings, each card, I kind of start from the beginning and go. For some reason for you guys, Spirit's telling me to go through all of the cards first. And I'm sure there's going to be a reason and we'll find that out. I've already done 10 signs and you guys are the first sign that this is going to be the way I'm going to read it. Finance and careers. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. With the Queen of Swords. Make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. Along with the Page of Swords. Very soon. Clearly decide what you want so that it comes to you now. And the King of Pentacles. Next to that, we've got pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Along with the Eight of Pentacles. Last card, Soulmate. Yes, this is your soulmate. Coupled with the Hanged Man. I'm gonna pull a couple more. I can see where this reading is already going, but let me just pull a couple clarifiers. There it is right there. There it is right there. Thank you, Spirit. Okay, guys. So there are several stories, several different groups of people that this reading is going to hit up on. So again, if it resonates, it resonates. If it doesn't, it doesn't. There is one particular group of people that are in a relationship currently. You are coupled. You are going through all of the steps. You're going to ascend to a higher level of commitment. Some of you are buying houses together. Things are moving quick. Chariot, quick movement, quick. Problem is, we have unrequited love here. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. That is right above, pay attention to the red flags. What I feel is a lot of you have rushed into something with the person that you're with. I feel like right now you're to the point where it's finally coming into clear view that this may not be the person you thought it was. This might not be the person that you want to spend the rest of your life with. The problem is, you may have bought a house. There's one, two, three pentacle cards, earth energy. One, two, three, four earth energy cards. We have got one, two, three sword cards. It could be an air sign. I needed more clarification on this reading, and this popped up. I needed this. You guys, swords, of course, are thoughts. Right now, a lot of you Cancer people are just drowned in your own thoughts. Things have been going so fast that you did not have a moment to stop and smell the roses until now. Now that you have pumped the brakes, so to speak, it's not exactly what you thought it was going to be. Not exactly. You are definitely trying to make the effort. But that unrequited love card here says that this is just not the person. It's just not. Yet another Pentacles card. I'm sorry, excuse me, this is the Cups, Six of Cups. Why am I saying Pentacles? Why am I feeling Earth so strongly? You also have the High Priestess, which to me symbolizes our intuition. I think some of you are ignoring that voice in the back of your head, that voice that's telling you, something doesn't feel right. I don't know, I'm not feeling it with this person anymore. But the problem is, you're in too deep, so to speak. It's never too late. Finances and career, you guys got a lot of bills together now. You have cars, house. You feel stuck. Queen of Swords is on there. To me, the Queen of Swords is, of course, it's an air sign. But she's a badass. Look at her sitting on her throne. She doesn't look upset. She doesn't look distraught. She thinks logically. She has her hand up in the air as if to declare something, to declare a thought. I think some of you need to declare your thought to your partner. This is just for some of you. Very soon. Clearly decide what you want so that it comes to you now. Decide what it is you want. Do you want to stay in this relationship to make the effort? Or is this something that you just can't see yourself doing for the rest of your life? King of Pentacles. Very soon, there's going to be another option. There's two options in his hands. That's how I look at this card. Very soon. Very soon what? Soulmate. Do I think the person that you're with right now is a soulmate? No. Maybe a karmic partner soulmate, but not a romantic love soulmate. We have several different types of soulmates. You can find soulmates in your family members, friends. They don't have to be romantic. This particular soulmate for this group of people, I do not feel like are your romantic soulmates. I don't. Justice comes up also. There will be justice. I feel like for a lot of you, you've been settling. You've given a lot into this relationship and it's going to come back to you. How is it going to come back to you? You know, this other card, where'd it go? This pentacle is being presented from the clouds, from spirit, so to speak. Spirit is going to give you this new opportunity, this new chance, this partner, this soulmate. Now, for those of you that are single, I feel like a lot of you have been just working very hard and not taking the time to smell the roses. Work has been your top priority, which is fantastic. That's great. I think spirit, though, is saying sometimes you have to stop, take a moment, take a breather. Let that energy dissipate. Because if you only focus all of your energy on one thing, you become oblivious to everything else, right? You get tunnel vision. Pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. This is for that group that I was just talking to. I'm sorry, I missed it. You see all of the signs around you, why you don't want to be with this person, why maybe you shouldn't be with this person. But you've been working so hard. Look at what you've accomplished with them. House, job, career, all these different things you've been working on, right? Oblivious to the signs, drowning yourself in everything to avoid the obvious, which is, this is probably not the right person for me. Release your ex. The time has come to clear your energy. Calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together. New love. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. This set of cards is for the singles. The single group. Single groups who were previously, very recently, in relationships. It's time to let go. It's time to completely, completely let go. You have called in your soulmate. This new love. Spirit, please tell me what signs or possible characteristic signs for this soulmate that's going to be coming in for Cancer for April 2017, please. Please give us some insight. This is for Cancer 2017, April, for love. This particular soulmate, please. Based on the cards, there are... Wow, there's more earth energy. So definitely strong earth. Could be an air sign, possible fire. These particular cards, these energy cards, these wand cards, three of wands and the six of wands, I feel like are you. right here, you're making that decision. What way am I going to go? What am I going to do? This is victory. Once you finally make your decision, you have the Judgment card. You're going to be declaring what it is you want. The Moon. There are two full moons here. Full moon was last night, full moon in April. Full moons are about releasing and letting go. Did we not just talk about that? Releasing and letting go. This is the Eight of Cups, which of course could be your energy. But looks like he is looking towards the horizon. He's ignoring these cups here. He's ignoring all these emotions, letting go of these emotions, releasing them, and looking at what's ahead. Page of Swords. Could be a younger person. Air sign, younger person. I'm definitely feeling a younger energy. This new person coming in is going to be younger. But I feel the new person is definitely an air sign. They're definitely an air sign. I'm going to go ahead and pull a couple of cards off of my Magical Mermaids and Dolphin deck by Doreen Virtue. Spirit, please give us a little more clarification. This is for Cancer for April 2017. I feel like a lot of you guys are stuck. Why are you stuck? Self-employment, you're a born entrepreneur and your business is surrounded by magical opportunities. I absolutely feel like a lot of you are drowning yourself in work, which is a great thing. That's fantastic. Focus on work. Great. But don't you want love? Some of you feel like it's time. You've put that on the back burner for too long. You're ready. Dream big. Let go of small thoughts about yourself. See yourself succeeding. Dream big. Look at her. She's resting. This, to me, speaks to you about dreaming big about your love life. I feel like a lot of you Cancers are set financially, set in your jobs, set in your careers. Not so much in love. Dream big when it comes to love, because you have called in a soulmate. Very soon, a soulmate is coming. Synchronicity. Your prayers and questions are being answered by synchronistic events. Notice them in order to increase their flow. See, there's a star up here. Make a wish on that star. Make a wish. What do you want? You see all of the signs around you. What do you want? Make your choice. Ready, set, go. Now is the perfect moment to dive in and embrace your heart's desires. Oh, Cancer. The way I feel right now is I feel like I'm stuck. Like I physically feel like I'm stuck in mud or stuck in sand. I feel like I have no energy to do anything. Is this how you guys are feeling? Is that why I'm feeling that way? I want you guys to take a moment. Take a moment to stop and smell the roses. I want you guys to take a moment to breathe. If things become too much, consult an expert. More information is needed. Contact someone with expertise in this area. Some of you guys need some help, therapist, psychic, just a friend, someone who's been in the same situation as you. You don't have to handle this alone. You don't have to handle this alone, Cancer. You're not alone. You have so many good things coming to you. Calling in your soulmate, new love, soulmate. Yes, this is your soulmate. Oh, I'm sorry. I got excited. If not now, very soon. How beautiful. Set your intentions. You've called them in. They're coming. It's on its way. It's a done deal. But you have to be open to that. You have to be aware. This person could walk right by you and you're so engulfed in all that's going on around you, your work, your stressful daily life, that you might miss them. They literally might walk right by you. They may sit next to you at a restaurant and you may not notice them. Stop and smell the roses, Cancer. If this reading resonated with you, please go ahead and like and subscribe. I am doing personal readings. If you would like to contact me for a personal reading, please email me at saltwaterhealstarot@gmail.com. Anyways, I wish you guys love and light, Cancer. I hope you have a beautiful April. Thank you.